Before the opening bell, U.S. indices closing higher on Wednesday, led by shares in banks, automobiles and components, diversified financials as well. On the economic docket, MBA mortgage applications rising by 10% in the week ended April 8th, compared to 2.7% the previous period, while retail sales, excluding auto and gas, improving in March by 0.1%, and PPI final demand dropping by 0.1% in March, therefore paving the way for advancers to be ahead of decliners. 78% of S&P 500 constituents trading higher yesterday. Now, after the market closed, Raytheon Company winning a $1.01 billion contract to supply aircraft jammer systems, this announced by the U.S. Defense Department. Facebook, meanwhile, creating a research lab to develop hardware products and hiring Regina Dugan, formerly the top research executive at Google, to lead the new lab, this reported by the Dow Jones. Meanwhile, Asian markets positive today, the Nikkei up 3.25%, the Hang Seng up 0.85%, and South Korea's Kospi up 1.75%. European markets, they are in the red, and U.S. futures calling for a soft open. Now, in terms of earnings today, Wells Fargo first quarter EPS seen at 97 cents, Bank of America first quarter EPS seen at 21 cents, while Delta Airlines first quarter EPS seen at $1.30 on sales of approximately $9.3 billion. On the economic docket, we have continuing and initial jobless claims figures at 8:30 in the morning, as well as March CPI figures. And we also continue to take a look at how the markets are shaping up. The S&P 500 sees limited upside. The relative strength index, that's mixed and calling for caution. So long positions above 2054 are favored, with targets at 2084 and 2090 in extension. The Nasdaq, meanwhile, seeing the bias remain bullish, preferring long positions above 4,500, and the Dow Jones sees the upside prevail, preferring long positions above 17,650.